Well, happy Wednesday, everyone. I'm SEU President Ken Engel, and as always, joined by our VP for Student Development, Bethany Thomas.
Hello.
And you're watching SEU Now, our weekly update show where we keep you informed and educated on everything happening right now at SEU.
Right.
Today, we're going to be talking about a very important issue, mental health and wellness.
Yep.
And here at SEU, we realize just how crucial it is for our entire community, our students, to prioritize their mental health, which is why we brought two special guests in on the show who can share all about the resources we have available for our students on campus and online and why those resources are so important. Joining us today in conversation is Kelsey Thomas, a licensed clinical social worker from our Campus Counseling Center, and Dr. Lisa Clifton, chair of the Department of Social Work and BSW Program Director.
Yeah.
Kelsey and Lisa, welcome to the show. Look forward to our conversation today.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
But before we get started, always, we want to fill in everybody on the top three things happening at SEU this week. Beginning tomorrow, January 20 through 21, Club Rush will be underway on El Prado.
So
that is from 9 a.m. to 3, right?
Yes, sir.
And this is always a fun event and one of my personal favorites, as it gives us a chance to learn about, you know, all the wonderful clubs that we have here on campus. Whether you're on the way to class or grabbing a meal at Toscana, I encourage you to stop by, check out. Trust me. You don't want to miss it.
Yep.
And there's always usually some goodies out there, too, you know,
snacks,
some cookies or something, you know. So head out and check it out. Second thing, this Saturday, January 26th, our men's and women's tennis teams will be kicking off the season at St. Leo University. Both games begin at 10 a.m., and I know these teams have been dedicated to their training and preparation for this season. So it's going to be quite a matchup. So go Fire if you can. Support them on those games. And then number three, lastly, we have a very exciting offer for our students, staff, and faculty. As a part of an initiative to really encourage people to get back into the community, the Florida Tropics are offering free general admission tickets to any of their home games at RP Funding Center with the purchase of parking. To sign up for your free tickets or to view the season schedule, all you have to do is go to floridatropics.com, floridatropics.com. And /TropicsBlitz and just pick up all your tickets for that. And they are an exciting team to watch. So I hope you can head out and take advantage of this offer. Well, let's start our conversation today. Yeah. And Lisa, I want to start with you about getting why is it so critical for our students to prioritize mental health right now?
Great question.
Well, if we think about our student schedules, they are just balancing a crazy amount. They're juggling just this avalanche of priorities. And I think about, especially at the beginning of the semester, when they're getting syllabus overload and all of those kinds of things. And so sometimes mental health takes a back burner because of the other priorities that they have. And so it's vital, we know, to our overall health. And yet it's sometimes easy to push back and think, oh, I can just deal with that later. I can push through it and deal with these other priorities. And yet we know the impact that it has on our relationships, on our physical health. And yet we sometimes choose not to prioritize it. So the more we can talk about it, the more we can talk about it in our community and appreciate that those challenges exist and we should address them, especially during tough and stressful times. And especially with our COVID and everything we've been dealing with over the last 2 years. So many students have had loss, you know, they've had anxiety, maybe even to a different extent than before. So, you know, it's tough to prioritize, but, you know, it deserves the same attention as our physical health. And sometimes we try to separate those out. And there's some stigma around that, right? We feel like if we address that, that we're somehow less than, particularly as a person of faith. I think it can be even, you know, more challenging because we sometimes feel like, oh, if I had a stronger faith, I've even had students share with me, you know, where they've been not really ostracized, but, you know, comments have been made to them. Well, if you just prayed harder
or
you just, you know, and so it's a real challenge for students sometimes because they don't want to feel less than when their peers are not seeking help. So I really think it's a it's not an either or proposition with faith. It's a both and. You know, and God's provided these resources for us. And we've got great opportunities for our students free, you know, with our counseling center. And so I just, you know, I hope that students would recognize, you know, even as believers, we're fallible.
Absolutely.
Right? And we have struggles. And so I hope that the students would begin to see that as a priority and the impact that it has on their whole being.
Yeah. Speaking of those resources you were talking about, Kelsey, give us a general overview of the different resources that students can do to seek counseling to support their mental health and wellness.
Yeah, so we actually have tons of resources available to students. Here on campus, we provide individual, couples, and groups therapy.
Yeah,
as well as we do twice a month on the lawn events. That's something new that we've been launching this semester, kind of talking about, you know, the stigma between mental health and faith, especially. So we go out, and it's on the lawn in between Smith Hall and Bethany and Bauer, and we're just doing a little drop-in, like mental health, wellness, letting them know, like, hey, we're counselors. We're not weirdos. Like, you can talk to us. This is fun. This is important.
Yeah.
No, that's great. And timely care sounds like an incredible resource. Share a little bit more about the services it offers and the cost to them.
Yeah, so Timely Care is an amazing, amazing resource for students. It's our teletherapy platform. We partner with Timely Care, and they have availability 24/7 for mental health care. There's an option for Talk Now that a student can press, and they're actually able to FaceTime within 7 minutes with a master's clinician. And then they also get 12 free sessions with a licensed therapist a year.
Wow, that's incredible.
And, there's a little cost to it, or what's the...
Completely free. Yeah, Southeastern covers the whole cost for SEU students.
Excellent.
That's incredible.
Excellent.
And now, who's eligible for these? Can online students access as well as our traditional students as well?
Yep. So traditional students, undergraduate and graduate, and then all of our extension sites, which is a really awesome resource. We actually have tons of kids using it from California, Washington, all over the states, getting 24/7 mental health care.
That's incredible. Mm-hmm.
Can you talk a little bit about the counseling center on campus and what resources it has available for the students?
Yeah. So we mainly offer individual counseling. Every student, traditional undergraduate, graduate, is eligible. And we provide individual counseling, couples counseling, and groups, actually.
Let me ask you this just as a follow-up. What about faculty and staff? Do they have any access, or is it just students?
Unfortunately, no, not at this time on campus. That's definitely something that we'd love to look forward to.
Great.
But right now it's just, traditional students.
Excellent.
Yeah. Now, Kelsey, what sort of subjects can students seek counsel on? Are there any kind of limits to what a student can schedule an appointment for?
That's a great question. Anything. We're here for you for anything that you need. We do... process like on a short-term model. So you get 6 sessions a semester completely free of charge. And then if there's stuff that you really need to continue working through, if there's a lot of trauma, there's just a little bit more than what our model provides, we do have referrals for the community.
And I think it's important for students to know, don't wait till you're in the middle of a crisis. You know, you can see things brewing sometimes.
100%. Tell us about the small group development and what's happening with that.
Yeah, so this year we've actually launched therapy groups here on campus, which is really awesome. We're looking to actually have 18 this semester being launched. Yeah.
That's incredible.
I know. I'm super excited. A variety of topics we're going to discuss. We have our own space in South Point, actually, that we're going to be able to meet. And just...
What types of topics in group counseling?
Yeah, so many, a huge variety. We're going to have a grief group. We're going to have an addictions group, anxiety group, calming your anxious thoughts, life skills, boundaries, relationships.
Yeah, that's good. Who leads these groups?
Yeah.
So they're led by our licensed counselors, our contract counselors, and our interns.
Okay, excellent, excellent.
Now, Lisa, from your perspective and range of experience that you have, can you talk to us a little bit about the value and benefits of group counseling?
Sure. It can be a little intimidating for some of our students to think about walking into a group setting. But when I think about groups, I think about community.
Yeah.
And I think that's how we were created. Mm-hmm. And so in a group setting, students have the opportunity, anyone who participates in a group, to really develop relationships, to develop rapport, to learn from one another, kind of in this laboratory setting. setting where they can practice skills in a safe space, and also get to see that they're not alone in their particular issue. And so, you know, we weren't meant to live in isolation. And sometimes when we're struggling, it's easy to turn inward and to not engage. And groups just give us such a great opportunity to step back into that space of community. And it creates an opportunity for some real healing as we work with our peers and we sense that community.
So true.
And final question this morning, Lisa. If there are any students, and I'm sure there are some students right now listening out there who may be very hesitant, very nervous to use any of these services or to attend a small group, what would be your encouragement to them?
Sure. I know it's scary. Yeah. It's scary to do something new and to step out and be vulnerable, but it's in that space when we take that step that we can find change and we can see that happen. So I just encourage students to take that first step. I know I, as a faculty member and other faculty and staff, would even be willing to walk with students to the counseling center if that would be helpful.
Sure.
You know, talk about, you know, what the process would look like ahead of time to maybe alleviate some fears. I know Kelsey's office will do that as well. So just, you know, to tell them that getting help is, it's not a sign of weakness. It's actually a sign of strength. And so, and it works. You know, I know Kelsey has multiple stories of doing the work and seeing this amazing change happen when students are willing to take that first step. And I do, it made me think too of Ecclesiastes, where it talks about two are better than one. You know, and when you have someone to walk through the journey with you, it's all the better. Again, that's how we were created. So that's counseling.
You're right.
No, that's so good.
It is.
Well, Kelsey and Lisa, thank you for joining us today
and
sharing about all these wonderful things, about the support and resources that we are able to provide all of our students. And I want to thank everybody for joining us today. As usual, keep up with the latest SEU news and updates online. Follow us on social media at SEU University. And at Kent_Engel. Hope everyone has an amazing week, and we look forward to connecting with you again next week on SEU Now.
Yay. Awesome. Yeah.